Welcome to this week's edition of Commissioner Time right here on St. Mary's County Government TV 95. I'm Tony Jones. This is where you get to hear from your elected county officials each week on matters of great importance to all of the citizens here in St. Mary's County. Our guest this week is Commissioner Dan Morris, who represents the 2nd District, and we want to let you know that this week we're actually on the road, the site of the April public forum here at the Hollywood Volunteer Rescue Squad. Commissioner Morris, thank you very much for joining us. Good to see you again.
Thank you, Tony. Thank you.
First question most folks want to know. The major part of the budget process is behind us now, and the county has approved a recommended budget. Now, you are one of two commissioners, along with Commissioner Jarboe, who voted against the recommended budget. Why did you give the thumbs down to the recommended budget?
There were a couple of items that I was not completely happy with. Number one, and I think the wording that went out to the general public saying a recommended budget, I looked at it more as a recommended draft budget, because we are not finished. We have some more work to do. I know that there are some things that I consider waste in the budget in different agencies, and I would like to hear from the directors and elected officials on this. And before I sign off on the budget, I don't want to have a conscience of I didn't do everything I could to cut the waste and to save taxpayer dollars. My perception of tax dollars is simply this, that it's not my money. It belongs to Tony, and it belongs to Bobby, and it belongs to Jim down the street. It's their money, so I have to look at it in that light, where I personally would lose perspective, because I think too many people in government look at it as an endless pot, and it's not. We have some thin ice ahead of us, and I still want to walk carefully on it. I expect that with two commissioners saying no to the budget, that people will look inside their own agencies and departments and say, okay, is there any waste here? I mean, I think that's their responsibility, too. It's not just my responsibility. I think it is everybody's responsibility who works in the county government. So for those two reasons, I wasn't happy that everything was done that I personally could do. I wanted the word draft in there so that people understood that this is not a finished product. Staff comes, our chief financial officer comes in, our administrator comes, and they're making all these recommendations, and they're very bright people, and you have to respect them because of their experience and their education and dealing with this. However, you know, I personally want to make sure that I'm comfortable before I sign off on that budget. Last year was a learning experience, and you know, after last year, and talking to people, well, if you're not completely happy, or at least 90% happy, which is most anybody can be, don't sign it. So those were my concerns. And one of the issues that I brought to the table was, why do we send our kids to school for a half a day? It's been a long time since I was in a classroom, even a college classroom, but I do know one thing. A half a day is a play day. That's what kids use it as. It's a play day. You can't get started before it's time to go home. So we're going to run school buses, and we're going to have schools heated or air-conditioned for a day when let's just shut the school down. If you need the time, if the teachers need the time, take a whole day off and get it all done at one time. And I understand the state puts regulations on us on how many days, but we can work that out to make the most bang for the buck. It's about the kids. So for those reasons, like I said, I wasn't real happy with it. I want to, you know, argue a little bit more with my other fellow commissioners. And sometimes you get them to see the light, and sometimes you don't. So and sometimes they show me the light. So but it's a good board, and I enjoy working with everybody on the board. So and another issue that has to do with the budget is the financial burden that the state has put upon us this year. I don't know if you were in there, but I'm walking back in, and it's one of our work sessions, and the county administrator says, oh, it's going to take $4.2 million to take care of the teachers' pensions, which the state, as you know, passed down to the counties. And I said, what happened to the $1.7 million? He says, oh, no, it's now $4.2 million, you know, worst-case scenario. And that's one of the topics I say we're walking on thin ice. We don't want to put ourselves underwater on budget issues on these times. So, okay.
Now, with all of that said, where do we go from here with respect to the budget process? We've got a recommended budget, or in your feeling, a recommended draft budget, but where do we go from here?
Well, I personally am going to look for more ways to save taxpayer dollars. The money belongs to the taxpayers. So I like the idea of the seniors' tax break, which the state has put an age limit of 65 years old. The county has an age limit of 70 years old. I know that that's a large impact because we have a lot of seniors here. But maybe there's a happy a medium where we can help our seniors. I have to look back at the ones that come to me and say, Danny, I need help with my taxes this year. All right. Not that we've raised the rate. The commissioners have not raised the tax rate in 2 years. But there are other influences on it. And when a retired person, for instance, is not getting any pay raise, yet their the medical cost of them living goes up, their spendable dollars go down. All right. So I understand completely their dilemma, and I want them to be here and comfortable and living a good life. Seniors, as you know, they are one of my major concerns. I would like to see something done as much as we can afford. We're going to look at other projects. I would like to throw a big kudos out to Brad Gottfried, once again, president of the College of Southern Maryland. We sat down and worked out a plan where retired military, and we have a lot of them here because of the base, can use the wellness center, the physical fitness center, and the pool, the aquatics, at a reduced rate. They don't pay registration, they pay a tuition, and that's it. I'm very, very happy with that, and I can't thank him enough. I think it was a step in the right direction, and I would encourage seniors and retired military to take advantage of it. It's a fun place to go. It's a wide range of ages, from college kids to World War II veterans I see and talk to. So it's really a wonderful facility. But I'm optimistic on the budget, and you know we'll get through it like we always do. Thank you, Tony.
All right, Commissioner Dan Morris, that's about all the time we have. We thank Commissioner Dan Morris for joining us here for this week's edition of Commissioner Time here on SCGD, St. Mary's County Government TV 95. I'm Tony Jones. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time.